we leveraged multiple content formats. So one is, you know, being genuine, storytelling, but your content also needs to be engaging. And by including multiple content formats into the answers, the content became engaging. We used images, videos, infographics. Now, you know, again, somebody's asked a question about procedure for closing a fixed deposit before maturity. Now, luckily for us, we were also managing the YouTube channel and video optimization for the client, right? So we are very familiar with the video content sitting out on the channel, made it easier for us to pick out the relevant videos and integrate that into our answers. So definitely the engagement on the answers increased. We got more upvotes, as a result of which the answer got more views. But because the answer got more views, it also meant that the video got more views. So adding or embedding videos in our answers not only helped us with marketing on Quora, but it also helped us with marketing on YouTube. So we were able to drive millions of organic views for their videos on the YouTube channel. And a lot of those organic views came from external sources like Quora, where we were sharing content. This is an example of an image that was embedded into an answer. So somebody is asking, how do I calculate my EMI? So rather than giving them a full explanation of how to calculate EMI, we've embedded this image where we've told them the formula, and we've given them a screenshot of a loan calculator, which is showing them it's a simple slider. All you have to do is drag it to calculate your, you know, to select the loan amount, the tenor, the interest rate, press a button, and it'll give you the loan amount, the EMI amount. And just above the image, there is a link to the EMI calculator. When you give that image, somebody sees it visually, how easy it is to calculate your loan EMI, and therefore they are much more likely in this case to click on that link and visit the website. And this is an example of an infographic. So somebody is asked, what are the different reasons I can cite to get an approval on my personal loan application? And this is a simple, you know, infographic which is saying, you know, these are the 7 reasons that you can cite. Again, effective use of footnotes and references. So this is a question where somebody is saying, I've got a CIBIL score of 832, what do I do? You know, what does this mean? Now, again, CIBIL is fairly complicated in the way it is calculated. There are so many FAQs around that. There's no point trying to answer your question or putting out all the details over here. What the team has done is they've given them a gist of what it means, but very subtly, using references and footnotes, they've linked out to an FAQ page which answers all the queries around CIBIL. So this is the other thing you need to keep in mind, that if you're using Quora and you're just, you know, embedding links left, right, and center, there's a good likelihood that Quora is going to ban your profile. So you have to be intelligent in the way that you are embedding links. We also facilitated quick resolution. So what that means is that we were very, very quick to respond to questions as they popped up on the platform. And the whole idea behind that was that we wanted to influence the consumer or the reader in our favor before the competition or somebody else had a chance to influence them otherwise. There are questions which require long answers, right? So what is the procedure for breaking my fixed deposit before maturity? Now, if somebody is asking for a process, it's going to be a lengthy answer. But there are many answers that need to be short and concise, right? It has to solve the user's problem quickly. If you do that, that is when you get the maximum number of upvotes, and obviously you end up getting large number of views as a result, right? So keep your answers concise on Quora. And lastly, you know, like I said, we had to drive scale. So it's obvious that since we are selling home loans and personal loans and all that, we are going to be tackling questions around home renovation and personal finance. But in order to get scale, we also jumped into a lot of other topics, popular conversations around vacations, weddings, education, basically anywhere that expenses were being discussed. And this really helped us get scale. So So, you know, with a mix of all these strategies and tactics, we were able to drive some fantastic results for the client. So this is one of the profiles. This profile has got more than 1.5 million lifetime views with over 163,000 views in the last 3 months. Another profile with 1.2 million views and 180,000 views in the last 3 months. And we've got multiple profiles like that. And our profiles have now become influencers in the relevant categories on Quora. So we've got one profile as the most viewed writer and another profile as the fifth most viewed writer in the personal loans category in Quora globally. We've got a writer who's the second most viewed writer in the home loans category. We've got two more profiles as the fifth and ninth most viewed writers in the overall loans category. Right? So while these authors were putting out great content, it translated into a 280% increase in Quora views over a period of 24 months. The views went from 40,000 views a month, around 40,000 views a month in April 17, to consistently over 160,000 views over the last 3 months. And this increase in views has resulted in a staggering 1,082% increase in referral traffic. I mean, this number is crazy. You can see we started out with less than 2,000 referral traffic back to the website on a monthly basis, and now it's very close to 25,000 referral visits. And not just referral traffic, it's translated into almost 5,000 leads being generated, and these 5,000 leads has translated into almost 15 crore rupees worth of online loan disbursals through Quora. So in my mind, I think this is a phenomenal campaign, started out with the objective of influencing customers on Quora who are doing their research there, and ultimately driving business objectives. And you know, after our success with this campaign, we've taken this and we've replicated similar results for customers in sports, in technology, in healthcare, and they've all benefited from using Quora. I would highly encourage everybody here to see how you could incorporate Quora into your content marketing strategy. And if you do choose to do that, then these are some of the key takeaways. Make sure that you stick with answering questions in your area of expertise. Be genuine. Use storytelling. You've already heard that enough times today. Use a mix of various content formats. I showed you how videos and infographics played a role in our case. Answer regularly to build scale. Keep it concise where it's possible. And while you're doing all of these things, please absolutely, absolutely make sure that you're not being overly promotional. You're not being very aggressive with embedding links, because if you do that, there's a good chance your profiles may get banned. So the trick is finding the right balance so you can keep your account alive and you can scale it up gradually.